This Photoshop, let's go to File menu and let's go to New and let's create a new document. Now for this tutorial purposes, I'm going to use 2000 over here, and then I'm also going to use 2000 over here, and then I'm going to set here to 72. I'm going to leave here RGB color, and then let's just call it retreat flyer. Alright, and then leave everything basically like this. I would like also like to change it to color white. Alright, click here, change it to color white. Okay, and then click on create. The next thing we are going to do is we are going to go to view, and then we want to set in our guard. So new guard layout, and then I'll set here to 6. Okay, and I'll set here to 6 as well, and then I'll click on okay. Now we're going to have something like this, quite interesting and quite nice. It's supposed to give me a white background. I don't know why it gave me this, but we can still work with it. All right, so let's start with our background, and then I'm going to leave all these things in the you know description for you to download them, and so just drag it into Photoshop. Now, guys, if you follow it into my blog, if you want to download this and you follow me into my blog, sometimes when you're trying to click on the link, it will keep on directing and keep on directing you to a different site. Don't worry, close it and come back again. Click on the link. You will get it, trust me. Okay, so we have something like this. Let's click on okay. Now you can see I've clicked on my move to here. Move to helps you to move the whole stuff. All right, so move to, that's it. And then let's also create a new layer. So we click over here to create a new layer. You can see the new layer over here, and then I'll click here and pick my brush, and then I'll come here and pick this particular color code F3802D. Okay, and then I'll go here and then make sure it is soft round brush. If you can't find it, just click on the general brushes and then click on the soft round brush. Also make sure the hardness is 0 and then increase the size of the brush. Now you can see the shortcuts here. I'll show you which, you know, key we use to increase the size, and just hit here like that. Okay, so I just painted just the underneath it, and then I'll reduce the opacity here to 5.5, make it a little bit subtle inside there. You can see, great. So we are done with that. I'd like to put it in a group, and I'd like to call it BG or background. I also want to bring in this particular oil splash in there. Just release it like that, oil splash. And you can see it fits in there nicely. Control T, and then I would, if you're using Photoshop CC 2021 or maybe 2022, 2023, chances are your shortcuts are also quite different like mine also. So I wanted to click on Shift and then drag it up. All right, great. Now if your Photoshop is, you know, CC 2018, the shortcuts are quite different and almost the same shortcut, but you know, there are just a few variations. Alright, so I'm going to have it like this. Now this is what I want to do. I want to go to the blending mode, and then I want you to click on, let me see, darken. I can see darken and multiply works well. Let's use darken. Okay, so darken it is, and then what else are we supposed to see? Let's bring in a new layer. Okay, and then let's choose our brush. Okay, so let's come here, let's choose this code. We are choosing FFF49F. Okay, it's not really white, but you know, we can do something. And then make sure your caps lock is off so that you can see the tip of the brush. Decrease the size of the brush, and then let's click somewhere somewhere here. Okay, so you can see it here, and then let's come here. Let's set it to screen. You can see it's brightened up. Let's hold alt and then increase it. Let's duplicate it. Click on your move to and then move it somewhere here. Okay, so we can have some tool glow over there. This is perfect. It gives it a very nice effect. Let's call it glow and oil. Now let's start with our text. So our text treat, and then I'll click on my text to type over here and paste it there. Okay, now let's start working on the details. Now the retreat, I want us to go here. If you can't find it, go to Windows and go and look for character. Okay, it's gonna pop up like that. And then we are going to use afterglow font. Okay, I'm going to leave in the description for you to download as well. So that is it. And then you're going to set a font size over here to 330, that's 330. And then you can see it is too stretched out, so the tracking here, let's keep it at zero, brings it together like that. And then let's leave everything like that. Click on the move tool and then move it somewhere here. Now let's see how it is. There are many things we would like to do to it again, so guys, don't worry, I think we even reduce the size a little bit more. Let's double click here. Let's go to the effects. Okay, now I want to give it a gradient overlay, so let's go to gradient overlay and then click here, double click here, 300E06. All right, okay, and then let's click here. Here is going to be FFA444 and click on OK as well, and then click on OK. You're going to set here to normal. Let's set the opacity to 100, and then over here let's set it to reflected. Let's see. Awesome. The angle here, let's set it to 32, and then the scale here, let's boost it to 20, and then let's see. I would like to take this one off, align with layer. Let's make sure it's unticked, and I think we are getting a very nice one there. Ooh, let's see. Okay, we'll work on it more, so guys, do not worry. The next one we also want to work on is the stroke. So let's give it a stroke here, and then the size, let's increase the size to 10, and then let's set here to outside, set here to normal, the opacity, let's set it to 100, the color, let's set the color to color white. Okay, now you can't see it, but it's there, trust me. And then let's also go to bevel and emboss. Bevel and emboss, we are using inner bevel. The depth, let's set the depth to 115, and then here let's set it to smooth. Let's set the direction to up. The size here, let's set the size here to 139, and then also the soften here, let's keep the soften at let's say 8, just a little small 8. Okay, and then let's see the angle here, let's keep it at 41. We want the angle to move from this side. You can see it is very nice. And then over here, let's give it a contour like this. Okay, now this is very important, guys. Don't forget the settings over here that I'm using. You're going to set here to screen, and then over here, click here, let's set it to FD843E. So you can see it has a little bit of that color in there as well. Click on OK. Click over here. Let's set it to 000000. Click on OK. All right. Let's also keep the opacity 50. The opacity 50 over here. Then we are done. Click on OK. So this is how it looks like. It looks interesting, right? So we are done with the retreat. But we'll work on the rest of the details later on. So let's click somewhere here. Alright, and then let's go and pick this two and paste it there. And drag it like that. We need to decrease the size, and so let's also use Montserrat for this. And then let's use semi bold for it as well. Let's set here to 50, and then let's set here the leading to 27. Awesome. And then let's set the tracking here to 0. Keep it italics, keep it all here bold. And then let's keep the color. Let's, which color should we use? Let's click here, let's choose this color 026 A66. All right, looks kind of greenish bluish. That's good. Double click it again. Let's give it some stroke. And for the stroke, let's click here. Let's give it these details. Like, you know, it's going to be 10 over here, outside over here, normal over here, 100 over here, white over here. Same thing, right? And then let's put it there. And then let's duplicate it and then bring it down again. Now, guys, pay really, really close attention to this, because this is very important. And then let's pick this church board, copy it, double click here, and then paste it. Awesome. Let's zoom in, drag it a little closer. Okay, a little closer. Okay, same settings. We're not going to do any match settings there, so that's it. Now Control H to bring our lines. Let's start with lookout church. Control T, let's see. You want to keep it in the middle of it. Awesome. Church board, you want to keep it in the middle of it. Awesome. Retreat, Control T. You want to keep retreat also in the middle of it. Awesome. And bring it down a little bit. Awesome. But here is the problem. It's too big, right? It's too big. So we are going to do one more thing. Let's duplicate this church board, duplicate it, and then send it up. And then let's pick a Denta branch. And then let's paste it in there. Okay. Now with that one too, let's work on the details as well. For Denta, just click here and pick any of these colors here like that. Alright, and then let's see, Control T, and then let's make it also middle aligned. Drag it a little bit closer to it. Okay. Now guys, this is what we are going to do. You can see all the text are over here, so let's select all of them into bracket, and then let's call it retreat. Control T. Alright, and then let's see how we can resize it. I feel like we should resize it more. Okay. Okay. I think this is great, right? Okay, so this is great. This is great. So this is great so far. We can manage this, right? Alright, so now let's bring in the other details. And so let's go here, and then let's see, let's bring in this one, Starburst. Okay, drag it in there. And then you want to resize it until it covers the entire canvas. Okay, this is good to me. Enter. And for this one, we want to give it divide. You can see it blends in there nicely. This is awesome. And then also let's give it some gradient to reboost the colors already in there. And so I'm going to give it a gradient map, and then I'm going to click here, double click here, and I'm going to choose FFC. Double click here, FFCC4D. Okay, and then over here I'm going to double click it, 4, 5, 1, 5, 1, 5. All right, now, okay. This is it, but this is not attractive. This is not guy. Okay, so what we are going to do now is set it to soft light, and you can already see that the colors are already coming out nicely. It's blending with the whole thing. So this is also what I like. I like to put both of them in a group, and then I'll call it sunbashed. So it's both the sunburst and then the gradient. I like it that way. And then let's see. Adenta branch. This. Okay. Okay. Now the next thing is, let's give it some little glow as well. So I'm going to pick my brush here, and then you know the color we chose already. FFFF. That's a 3 F's and then 4, 9 F. Alright, and then clicks over here, and then I'm going to set it to screen. You already know screen over here, and then click on my move to control T, and then hold shift depending on the version of Photoshop you are using. Duplicate it, and then I'll bring it somewhere here again. I like that because it's already making everything stand out. Alright, so I'll put them in a group and I'll call them glow. So we are done with the glow as well. Maybe let's decrease it a little bit. Let's see. So I decrease it to 76%. I think that one is good. Now let's also give it some vignette. Okay, so click here. Sorry, let's go here. Let's choose solid color. Let's choose color black. All right, and then let's set it to 50%. Click over here. Click on your brush to make sure caps lock is off. Increase the tip of your brush. Okay. Increase the tip of your brush, and then make sure here is color black as well, and then keep on increasing the tip of your brush, and then let's hit here. Make sure opacity is 100 and then flow is 100, and then just hit there. Continue hitting there, continue hitting there. Okay, like it like that. As well. Alright, so that way the vignette is there nicely. Okay, keeping the focus on what is in the middle. That is the importance of the vignette I'm using. And then let's bring in some venue. I would like to draw a rectangle around here. Pick this, draw a rectangle around here. Make sure the fill here is color of white, and then drag it down. All right, let's write the venue there, and the venue is this. Paste it there, click on the move tool, and then move it all the way in here. Click on your character, and then let's start working on the details. We are going to use Montserrat. We are going to use bold. Let's set the font size to 67, and then the tracking, let's keep it at 0 here. Let's make it italics here. All bold should be taken off. Click on the color. Let's give it a color so that we can see it is 2E2C2B. Okay, and then let's duplicate it and bring it down, and then let's go, and then let's pick this, double click it and paste it there. And then with this as well, we are going to choose the same colors, okay? But we are going to do two things over here. We want the prompt over here to be medium, all right? And then we want the 8 over here. Let's give it a different color. Let's give it 460D03. Okay, and then let's drag it closer to it over here. Nice. Let's pick our logo, drag our logo in there. Resize our logo, move it here like that. Select them, put it in a group. Let's call it venue, and then let's keep it in the middle. Drag it down here as well, in the middle of everything, okay? And then let's drag this down here like that. Okay, let's drag the venue up to a little bit. So we are done with that. Okay, now let's add some few things to it to make it more interesting. Let's add our 2023, my year of faithfulness. Come here. We are going to use semi-bold for it. And then we are going to set it to color black. Let's see whether color black is going to work. Let's decrease the size of the font over here to 23. Nice. Over here, the track, let's set it to 100. No, let's 2500. All right. Enter. Control T. Rotate 90° counterclockwise. And then move it there. All right. All right. So let's see how it looks like. In fact, let's keep it here like this. All right. So everything is done, but the color doesn't look boosted up. It doesn't look too attractive, you know. The color is not really blending well, even though this is nice. I always like to give it a finished touch, you know, my own signature. So what I'm going to do is Control Alt Shift E to merge everything on one particular layer. You can see it over here, right? Now this may not work for you, but this is how I like to blend all my colors and everything, is to make it to boost a little bit. All right, so I'm going to go here, set it to soft light as a finished touch. I'm going to leave the opacity and the fill to 100%, and then this is it. So this is the final work, guys. So guys, if you love this particular video, please hit the bell icon and subscribe to this channel. But guys, remember one thing, remember I want you to subscribe to this channel, okay, so that you can get more updates, and anytime I release new video you will not miss out on it. Also, very importantly, this particular flyer is part of my flyer packages that I'm selling, you know. And so these are all of them. I decided to design from this one. So if you still want to get all of them, guys, this is how you're going to get it. I'm going to leave a link in the description. It's going to lead you over here, and this is it. You are going to find it over here. All right, so you're going to find it over here. You can see 50 plus flyer templates. You just have to click buy now, and then it's all yours. Each and every single one of them. Every flyer you see over here is part of the flyer package, and there are many more as well. All right, so guys, I love you all. See you in the next tutorial. Peace.